Today, I introduce you to one of the best-selling French artists and singers and performers, Mylène Farmer. Now, I want to get into this very quickly because there's such a lot to get through about this woman, but I want to no longer take more than 5 minutes. So she's known as Mylène Jeanne Gauthier, known professionally as Mylène Farmer, and she's a Canadian-born French singer, songwriter, occasional actress, writer and entrepreneur. And having sold more than 30 million records in France, she is the most successful recording artist of all, one of the most recording artists of all time in that country. And she holds the record for the most number one hit singles in the French charts, with 21 to date, 8 of which were consecutive. And we're going to feature her biggest number one and her most popular. I don't want to go through too much of her personal life, but I do want to go into, where is it? Musical style. Musically, Farmer is usually described as a pop and French artist. Nevertheless, she's known for reinventing her style with every album cycle. Now, to all her fans, she is coming out, she's been hinting from 2021 that she's coming out with an album in late of this year and a tour in 2023. So that's ahead of her. And she's just recently separated in 2022, so I'm sorry to hear that. But when we get on to the song itself, this is one of the most interesting songs I've come across. It's called Déchanté, and Déchanté was a song that during in 1991, when President Mitterrand was running the country, people who supported President Mitterrand in the elections and the re-election of him used the song almost politically. And for Mylène, she said that she personally didn't write the song as being a political song, but yet the person that she wrote it with had a different point of view. And there's been two versions of this particular single put out there, I think, to reflect both points of views about what both writers got out of the song. Because the song, even though it was written by Mylène Farmer, was also composed by Laurent Boutonnat, who has been so involved with many of her albums. Boutonnat, sorry, has been so involved with many of her albums, as I've said. And he just had a different point of view. And I'm going to give you the two points of view before I play the song. And she did mention, as I said, she didn't find it political. And I'm just going to come up with, I believe that one undergoes one's life, one's death. In this matter, one cannot be fundamentally interventionist because remember, I told you it was associated with politics. So she's saying she separates from that. I have a problem with life, but I live, so everything is not as bad as you think. But for the other guy, the other person that wrote the song with her, the song is a spotlight on a generation in need for a future. And when he aired his views, young people supporting President Mitterrand used it as disenchantment, their dissatisfaction with different things, and it became a political record that they sang. So you're going to see in the audience a mixture of excited fans of all generations, and particularly older people from the 1991 era, who probably used that song to represent their future in France and that particular feeling. But as she said, it was one outlook that Laurent had about writing it. But my request is fundamentally, she said, it was a bit of, in the lyrics, narcissistic, egotistical. I cannot advocate negativism, which she associates to politics, affirming it. It's not pessimism to think that in 1999 we have become more lucid since then and more aware of our disillusions than before. But it wasn't her intention to have it political. So I wanted to make that clear because a lot of fans wondered what she thought, and that's what she thought. I'm exhausted. After 5 minutes, we're going to listen to the concert version of it. As I said, if you do seek out the video, it's quite grim and Bleak, and I will give you a description of that video in my description attached to this, if that makes sense. So you've got my verbal explanation of what fans wanted to know. You've got the description of the video. Why is it bleak? Why she got her hair cut short? And now you've got the live concert version and why there's such a mixture. And wait till you see the crowd that sings to this particular song. Take it away, Million Farmer. I'm going to go very quickly through the lyrics after this because this video is also 5 minutes long. Take it away. And this is an edited version of the 10-minute song.
Thank you.
Now, everybody, that was the version. And I'm going to bring this down because that was an ad that came up. And I'm going to give you my interpretation of what that song was about. Because I have to say, everybody, that when it comes to songs, never have I been involved with something that I thought was so deep and so political, but it divides people. Some people take the lyrics in one way, and usually I give an interpretation of what I think the lyrics is about. But because this holds such a political belief to, and it was held in high regard in 1991, and there's many people in France that still affiliate that to the political new generation of President Mitterrand's reign, I will keep as true to the lyrics as I can. And I also have an answer from somebody. But we will go into the lyrics, I think. Or do we do the answer first? I think I'll give you a comment made by a fan. It says, "One of the things I've learnt over the years is that it's dangerous for others to speak about the meaning of an artist's work, be it a painting, sculpture, or song, and those presumptions to regurgitate it to what others believe the work to be." And he goes on to mention something here. For many of us in our late teens and early 20s around this time, the fall of Berlin Wall was the greatest single event that defines the generation. The Cold War was won at that point. And the scene where Marlene leads the escape, and this is going back to the video. This is why I didn't take on the video from inside the prison. Onto the sea ice is like the fall of the Berlin Wall, he says, and German reunification, freedom at last. The scene in the video on the sea ice is Eastern Europe's coming to grips with what freedom is. So he comes from a political point of view, what the song meant for him, and how he tied it into the politics. And that is the point of this speech. A lot of people feel very, very strongly. So I have to be very careful how I interpret the lyrics because there's two complete viewpoints on this. And then he asked about, or he wondered what Malene's point of view, and I've already mentioned it. She dissociates herself from that and puts it towards being liberal and wanting to be free and not being afraid of that. So, and that is very relevant to the to today. And believe it or not, the politics of those years, 81, no, sorry, 91, is now relevant to today because the Cold War could happen again. It's come around. So that's why I'm playing the song, because it holds national importance in other countries, Austria, Belgium. They all feel it's a political song too. And I'm sure when she wrote it at the time, she must have said, I would never have considered one of my songs political. But you've seen the fans' response there. They just absolutely just worship her like a goddess, and they sing along with it, and everyone sings along for their own reasons. It's the most diversive song for their own reasons. Now, around that time, you had Madonna, and she sang Material Girl, and that was also a hit at politicians and the lavish lifestyles they led at the expenses of the people's taxes that they collected. And a lot of people don't know that, but she did write that because of that. She was a clever lyricist as well. But we now go into the lyrics itself. Says you, hee. And we get, I've given you the background, the bio, the build up to it, the artist herself. And now we have to go, as I said, to the English lyrics. Swimming in the troubled waters of forthcoming days, waiting here for the end, floating in the too heavy air of the almost nothing, to whom should we hold out our hands? And you can see where the people are getting from the lyrics. We are like the people holding out our hands to President Mitterrand. You make sure that our future is good. We're holding out our hands. We're raising our hands saying, you get into power. That kind of thing. If I must fall from high, let my fall be slow. I haven't found rest, but indifference, and yet I would like to recover my innocence. But nothing makes sense anymore, and nothing's fine. Everything is chaos by comparison. All of my ideals, damaged words. I'm looking for a soul who'll be able to help me. And I am a disjointed generation. Disjointed. And when it comes to disjointed, it means a generation that's cut off from reality. They don't know where they are. They're confused. Help me be unconfused. So again, you can see that political divisiveness from other people who say it's not. Laurent, Meline, who wrote it with Laurent felt it was. Meline said no, but I can see, I could give you my interpretation that would be totally non-political, but I'm leaning towards the politics of this because I lived in the 90s. So I can see this, and it continues. Who could keep me from hearing everything when reason collapses? Which way to turn? Who can pretend to lull us in one's womb? So it's like a politician taking these people and putting it in. You're my babies. You're gonna grow with me and the my policies, and you're going to be okay. And when they come to fruition, you will be a new person in a new world. That kind of thing. If death is a mystery, it continues. Life isn't exactly tender. If heaven has a hell, then heaven can't be. Can still wait for me. Tell me how to handle this headwind. Nothing makes sense anymore. Nothing's fine. There was a lot in the 90s of disorientation of where people would go. There was plentiful money coming in. Politicians were never as rich. People were never as rich. Buying your own home, everything was fantastic. But yet people were lost. There were still lots of people without money, struggling people, people dying in the hospitals. There was a lot of normality. But propaganda and the media kept focusing on how wonderful we are. And Russia isn't as powerful as they think. Look at the medals we're winning in. And they compared that power they had to medals in the Olympics. But that's a politician for you. Most of them are very uneducated. So it continues. Everything is chaos by comparison. All of my ideals, damaged words. I'm looking for a soul who'll be able to help me. And I am from a disjointed generation. So people looked to President Mitterrand for this. They looked for, please help us, please. It was almost like a French Revolution. And they used it, if you were a Mitterrand supporter, this song was used as their chant. And they would sing it at rallies and stuff and clap their hands and everything. And it was really to gain momentum for a new future with a re-elected president. And this song was chosen. Finally finishes. Everything is chaos by comparison. All of my ideals, damaged worlds. I'm looking for a soul who'll be able to help me. And I'm from a disenchanted generation. Isn't it crazy? Who'd have thought in 2022, from 1991, because this is when the video is made, that karma would have come round to bite again and say, hey, it hasn't gone away. You have Russia's president wanting his country to go back to, Russian domination, Iron Curtain built again, and no more Western interference. You've also got the Western world provoking one of the, Russia, and antagonizing a situation to gain a political profile, and that's the Ukraine situation. A lot of politicians are using this situation. And who is disenchanted? The people. Around the world, people are upset over the people of Ukraine's debts, and on top of that, people are disenchanted again throughout the world because of what politicians are doing. We have some of the most ludicrous leaders in the world. Boris Johnson, Biden, Macron seems to have, in France, in your country, France seems to have calmed down a lot since being re-elected. But he also used the Ukraine to get there. Everybody has taken a piece out of, and the Canadian Prime Minister at this time, I'm not even going to mention his name, I have no respect for. I think the guy should be in hospital on medication for some of the policies he's come out with. But there's a new generation growing up disenchanted. What's going to happen? Because this time around, after a pandemic, we don't have, like in 1991, there was plenty of money going around. This time around, we don't have plenty of money. But yet, this particular song is very relevant to what's happening now. Isn't that an incredible thing to know, that your song keeps repeating itself as history repeats itself? So that is my conclusion to everything. I hope you've enjoyed the background, the bio, and everything to this particular song. Please like, please comment, please subscribe. I look forward to you joining my channel. Au revoir, français. And bienvenido to all the Spanish people listening, and goodbye, everyone.